Tell us about your parents' divorce and the impact that you feel it had on you. Talk to
Yeah,
us.
so one, I want to preface it this way. I grew up in a home that was, since we were like relatively Christian, I had both my parents, my dad especially, would always, I remember he always said this throughout my entire life. He said he would always use us as an example to other people because I have a lot of friends who didn't have homes where their parents were together. Like most of my friends at this time were from divorced homes. And I felt like such an, I was so grateful. I remember distinctly having this memory throughout my childhood at different points that I was so grateful that I was not from a, like, because I felt so sad. You know, we'd have Christmas that'd come around. My mom would make things so special for us, and we'd all get around the tree, and we had Thanksgiving, and we, you know, my dad would be in the kitchen, and my mom would be in the kitchen. They'd be making a meal, and like we had all sorts of family, and I just thought family was the best thing ever. As much as I had like a disturbed view of my parents and like and then them not loving me, I never changed the fact that I wanted their love, which is why I chased it. And that became my identity at the at, in my childhood, because now my identity was resting in the fact of like earning my parents' love. Now, as disordered as that is due to what happened to me, it doesn't change the fact that I just loved our family. Like I really loved having family, and I felt sad for people who didn't have that and who had to go to their, you know, and you would hear my friends and stuff would try to make it sound all nice, like, oh yeah, but my dad likes me play video games till midnight, and then my mom, she makes me do too many chores, and you know, and you'd hear these things, and I'm just like, I would, there was something intuitively like wrong about that feeling of like, what? Like, so your mom's trying to teach you to do the right things, but your dad's over here letting you do the wrong things. Like, how confusing is that? Like, or vice versa, you know, your dad's trying to do whatever. And so anyway, I, my parents, my mom had always, and my dad had always said, at least you are growing up in a home where both your parents love each other. I heard that line verbatim my entire childhood. I'm sure my brother and sister could attest to that as well. And I, it was the affirmation that you're right. Like, yeah, we have a good, you know, we're have two parents who love each other. What else could you want? Well, when the divorce came around, I was 18 years old, and it was a pretty ugly divorce. It went over the course of a couple years, I want to say, and it was not a pretty time. But when that happened, mind you, I want to go back to the whole like idea of this childhood secrecy that I've been holding, the secret of like, and not only that, but that's what propelled my identity at this point. What propelled my identity was doing whatever I could to get both my parents' love. When they broke up, I had no identity anymore because I took their divorce as a sign that our family wasn't good enough. I'm not good enough. It was like instantly that moment. I couldn't have articulated this then, but in that moment when they split up, I felt like that the love I had been chasing my entire life secretly, it was like that was them telling me like, yeah, you're not good enough. You answered my question. And I can't tell you that just really shaped the next 15, 10, 15 years of my life.